Hello, everybody. Not as fan here with you today. I'm bringing you more from our Madden 15 connected franchise, online connected franchise. I told you the Junk Gaming Videos is running with the Jacksonville Jaguars, and here is his week one game against the Philadelphia Eagles. Yeah, he's got to start out on the road against the Eagles, a team who is a division foe of mine, as I am taking the New York Giants. Now, remember, I lost my game in overtime to the Detroit Lions. That was up yesterday on the channel. Now, whether you're watching this on Sports Gaming Universe or Junk Gaming Videos, you get to see his squad here, led by Blake Bortles. Now, before we get too deep into this game, I know some of you might have some concern about the well-being of Junk Gaming Videos, as he has not been in one of his comms here in about three videos. I've done them in his place instead of our dual comm, or instead of him doing the commentary solo. Well, the fact is, I've got him locked in a closet doing nothing but recording Madden 15 for me. Yep, I'm working him like a slave. Okay, no, that's not actually the case. It just worked out that we edited this last night, and it was 11:30 at the night, and he was tired, so he went home. So here we go. We've got the game. 3rd and 7. They don't connect right there. It's going to be a punting situation. Here comes Nick Foles and Shady McCoy. We've all heard and seen a lot from Chip Kelly's high-tempo offense, and this is something Jacksonville will have to be very mindful of. Here comes LeSean McCoy again, trying to break outside, does not quite get there, but he has a nice run yet again, and here will be a first down run. Jacksonville so far, no answer to McCoy on the ground. Here's Foles wanting to throw, and this is out to the flat, and it's McCoy catching the pass and getting a first down and trucking somebody at the end there. Nice job, as LeSean McCoy is in full gear right now. But here is newly acquired Darren Sproles. He is part of that 1-2 punch now. And so you got him in there when McCoy gets tired. But McCoy back in the game and punches it in the end zone. The Eagles strike first on that convincing drive, and the home folks are happy as LeSean McCoy punches it right in here. He says, "Get out of my way." So it's 7-0 Philly. First quarter almost over. Now, we have made the decision to make the league be 10-minute quarters after week one. So after this game, we will have 10-minute quarters from here on out. Here is Blake Bortles trying to get away. Don't know exactly where he's going. I don't know if Junk knew where he was going either, but he gets sacked. And, yeah, they lose a lot of yards there. So they got to punt the ball. 3rd and 9. Foles throws that one right into the ground before he gets hit. So they need to punt. Not much going on here right now for offense. That ball swatted away. Jacksonville will punt. A lot of three and outs going on right now. Second quarter action. Foles has a pump fake. He's going to step up. He's going to throw it downfield. And what a catch! Did you see that catch? We're going to show it one more time. But that was a one-handed beauty as he was getting hit. This is quite an amazing catch right here. And a feat of concentration. Is that Aurelius Ben? Man, what a catch. Okay, handoff to McCoy. Right up the gut and into the end zone again. 14-0 Philly as they're pouring it on in Jacksonville right now, who really seems to be undermanned at this point. But we'll have to see what's going on. I guess that's what happens when you pick Jacksonville to run with, huh? There's going to be some growing pains. Bortles has a first down pass right there, though. He's a strong point right now. Only 4 of 11 for 42 yards. But, hey, got to start somewhere. Hopefully he can dial it up. We're going to hand off to Toby Gerhart. He's going to fight hard right there for a few yards. That'll make it 2nd and 4. So as we're almost at the 2-minute warning, Bortles over the middle is going to make a connection right there. Nice pass. Nice catch. That's Mercedes Lewis getting into the action. 2nd and 22 after a sack. Bortles is going to find his man again and get some of that back. Can we get a score before the half? Well, it would be very important here. Bortles on the play action, and he's going to get picked. Stepping right in front of that and picking it off. Yep, that's going the other way. Not good. Not good at all, as we're already down 14. Foles here on 2nd and 10 is going to get a first down. And the Eagles are thinking about trying to get one here before the half expires. Foles now over the middle, and that will be good. Is that Jeremy Maclin? Foles has got something going now. 23 seconds left. And he's going to get sacked. No, he pushes him off. And he throws deep to the end zone. Luckily, that is knocked down by Jaguars defenders. So we got a long field goal. What is that, about 54 yards? Oh, he sneaks it in there. What a kick. 54-yard field goal makes it 17-0 Philly. Just 8 seconds left, and Bortles is going to throw deep for Justin Blackmon. Yes, I know he's suspended in real life, but right here he's making a big-time catch and a first down. He kept 2 feet in bounds. Are you kidding me? 2 seconds left, and they might have set up a field goal opportunity. Nice catch and concentration by Justin Blackmon. Again, not in the league in real life this year, but Junk is choosing to run with him here, which he needs all the help he can get. That kick is good, so they do break the shutout and get 3 points. Well, really kind of lucky to get those right before halftime with the long pass, so they'll take it. So they got to regroup, and it is now halftime.
All right, welcome to the Verizon Halftime Report. Let's take a look back at the first half. The Eagles want to continue to give their fans something to cheer about in the second half. The Jaguars know it's always hard to come in and get a win on the road, but they're not out of this one yet. All right, let's get straight to it. Here's some highlights from the first half.
We're actually going to bypass those highlights and just get on into the second half here now. So the Eagles have the ball up 17-3. Sack! Nice play right there by Bryant, coming over from the Seahawks and trying to help out this defense. He gets a sack right there. The goal is to play better than the first half. Foles does not want to go down easily, but he does get sacked by Marks right there. Junk likes to refer to him as Richard Marks. Yeah, I know. Okay, so that pass is going to be broken up. Yeah, it was Bortles trying to get a first down as we got the ball back, but not for long. Had to punt it right back. Here comes Foles again. Going to hit there for a pass to the sideline. And now on first and 10, he's going to be chased down. Again, he doesn't go down on the first hit. He slips that. But Marks is there again for his second sack. The defense tightening up a little bit here in the second half. Blitz, and he's drilled. Oh, my goodness. Luckily for the Eagles, McCoy was there to scoop that ball up. But Foles was absolutely destroyed on the play. It's good to see he's back up because he got hit hard. Third and 29 now. They need a ton. And they're not going to get it. That could have been picked, but instead it is knocked down, and the Eagles will have to punt, but they are still up 17-3. So the defense looking much better in the second half. How about the offense? Toby Gearhart's going to rip off a first down on a draw run right there. He's got 5 carries for 40 yards. It's too bad we're down 17-3 because we can't really effectively get that running game to continue. There is a first down pass, so Bortles connects once again. And looking to just get down and get in the end zone for starters. 29 seconds left in the third quarter. Play action, and that's going to be a nice catch right there. It's Mercedes Lewis once again as he makes a tough catch in traffic. Now a handoff to Gearhart. He's going to get out to the outside and spin down about 2 yards short of a first down. Bortles wants to throw over the middle, and that's another tough catch. Wow. Right in traffic there, Mercedes Lewis again as you see the opponents coming up next. Redskins are going to be next up on the schedule. So, but right now we're just trying to get in that end zone, and there's first and goal. He's working Mercedes Lewis on this drive, and he is responding. So on second and goal, throw to the end zone is picked off. Oh no, thrown into traffic, and it's picked off. Going the other way. Bortles tried to force that throw for a touchdown, and instead it is an interception for Ryans, taking it back the other way. Ah, shoot. Rookie mistake right there, I guess. That's a nice play, though, to pick that off and thwart any chance Jacksonville had on that run. Shady is picking up another first down and probably just going to try to kill this clock out the best they can. Look at Foles, avoid another sack, and he's going to throw this downfield. Oh, man, that was almost another crazy catch, but it is knocked away. So we get the ball back. Bortles looking to throw again. He's got to make this all the way down the field and somehow not turn the ball over this time. That's Marquise Lee out of USC making a catch. Bortles is going to go deep. One-on-one. No, it's going to be picked off. That plan didn't work well. That's essentially going to seal any chance that Jacksonville has right now as we're 3 minutes and counting. Foles is going to run for it. No, he turns around awkwardly and throws, and he still somehow gets a first down. Wow, that hurts right there. When they can connect and convert on that. Under 2 minutes now. McCoy is going to run for whatever he can get on third and 11. Timeout called. Jacksonville's now out of them, and they get the ball back one last time. 1:40 to play. There is a catch and a first down by Robinson. Okay. We got two Robinsons here. We got Denard Robinson and we got Allen Robinson. That was Allen, and that is Mercedes Lewis. 4th and 10. Gotta have it. Not gonna get it. It's not a sack, but the ball falls to the ground, and Jacksonville is gonna fall 17-3. All the scoring done in the first half. So both our teams go 0-1 in week one, looking for better results in week two. Come on back. Tomorrow should be the New York Giants, my franchise team, and we'll try to alternate these working through the season. We'll see you next time, guys. For Junk Gaming Videos, I'm Not As Fan. Later.